Hello everyone, myself Kathy Vyas from JMP English Medium Saraswati Group of Education. Today I am conducting this session for grade 6. Subject is SS. We are dealing with chapter number 1, introducing history, and this is my session number 4 for this chapter. So kids, in our earlier sessions, we have already completed explanation part of this chapter and also the CW part 1 is being sent to you. In today's session, I am going to deal with the textbook exercise that is given in this chapter. But the full CW work I am going to explain in this video. Clear kids? I hope the part 1 of CW which I have already sent to you, you have also marked the answers in your textbook with the help of a pencil. In today's session, we will discuss whatever is already sent to you. I have already sent to you part 1 in which we have covered the vocabulary, meaning. Then from the exercise, I have sent main question 8, that is choose the correct answer and fill in the blanks. And main question B, state whether true or false. And this time if the statement is false, you have to also correct the statement and then rewrite it. This was already given to you in part 1 CW work. Part 2 CW work consists of the question answers. But in today's session, we will discuss the full exercise of this chapter. So let us start that. Firstly, I will start with main question 8, that is choose the correct answer and fill in the blanks. Main question B, state whether true or false. If false, then correct the statement. Then answer the following questions. Here you are having first one 10 to 20 words, then 50 to 70 words, and then long answers for 80 to 100 words. As you are all grown up now, you have to practice to write long answers, memorize long answers, all these things. Okay, अब आप बड़े हो गए हो तो long answers भी आपको memorize करने हैं, सीखने हैं. By heart मत करना, answers को समझने के बाद own words में लिखना सीखो. By heart करोगे, mug up करोगे तो it will be difficult for you to answer them in the exam. Okay, so it is my humble request कि आप answers को by heart नहीं करोगे, उनको समझने की कोशिश कीजिए और उनको own sentence में लिखने की practice कीजिए. Clear kids? Now let's start the exercise. Question A, choose the correct answer and fill in the blanks. If you have not ticked the answers in your textbook, please tick the answers with a pencil along with me through this video. Question number 1. Historians divide the past into dash periods. Options are 2, 3, 4 and 5. The correct answer is 3. Clear? Next. Number 2. Prehistory refers to the dash. Prehistory kise kehte hain? Options are the period after the invention of writing, the period of digging into the earth, the period before the invention of the painting, the period before the invention of the writing. Prehistory matlab written records nahi the. So that means option D is the right answer. Prehistory refers to the period before the invention of writing. Next, dash is an archaeological source. Inme se kaun sa ek archaeological source hai? Options are inscriptions, notebook, book, puzzle. Answer is inscription, option A. Next, manuscripts are dash. Options are handwritten records of the past, oral records of the past, painted records of the past, musical records of the past. So manuscripts are option A, handwritten records of the past. Next, number 5, the southern gate of Sanchi Stupa was added by dash. Options are Ashoka, Chandragupta Maurya, Satakarni and Samudragupta. Answer is option C, Satakarni. Now let's move to the question B, main question B. State whether true or false. तो पहले आपको ये लिखना है कि दिया गया स्टेटमेंट ट्रू है या फॉल्स है. अगर ट्रू है तो इट इज ओके एंड इफ इट इज फॉल्स तो आपको करेक्ट क्या है वो लिखना है. क्लियर. फर्स्ट वन, द इंस्क्रिप्शंस ऑफ द मौर्यन किंग अशोका आर द अर्लीएस्ट इंस्क्रिप्शंस इन इंडिया. इज इट ट्रू? यस, इट इज ट्रू. सो राइट ट्रू. नेक्स्ट, नंबर 2, लिटरेरी सोर्सेस आर ऑफ टू टाइप्स, रिलीजियस एंड सेक्युलर. यस, दिस इज ऑल्सो ट्रू. नेक्स्ट, थर्ड नंबर, BCE स्टैंड्स फॉर बिफोर क्रिश्चियन एरा. इज इट ट्रू? No, it is false. So write the correct statement. Correct statement is BCE stands for before common era. Next, number 4. Arthashastra was written by Kautilya. Is it true? Yes, it is true. Next, number 5, the Vedas and the Puranas are classified as sacred and religious literary sources. Is it true? Yes, it is true. Now moving on to main question C, that is answer the following questions in 10 to 20 words. Question 1, please listen to the answer and try to understand them. Answer is, history is the systematic record of the past events. Many of these records were done on rocks, clays, barks of the birch, etc. Question number 2, define archaeology. The science of exploring and excavating old remains is known as archaeology. Number 3, what is a manuscript? Answer is, manuscript is handwritten record of historical events. Next question, what are fossils? Answer is, fossils are remains and imprints of plants, animals or humans preserved in rocks which have been buried from millions of years. Next, number 5, what are artifacts? Answer is, artifacts are human-made objects like tools and implements, ornaments and pottery that have been found in various archaeological findings. Am I clear? Let's move on to the main question number D. Answer the following question in 50 to 70 words. Means here you have a bit lengthier answer. Now you are grown up, so you have to increase your IQ level. Clear? Let's start this now. Question 1. Why do we need to to study history? Answer is, we need to study history because it tells you about past settlements, economy and the society. It also tells us about clothes and the foods of the people, their beliefs, their faith and their work. The study of history explains how such changes have taken place over a long period of time. It tells us how human beings gradually made discoveries and inventions which led to their development. Therefore, history helps us to understand our present and mold our future as well. Next question. How do coins help us to understand history? Coins help us to understand the economic condition of the kingdom in which they were issued. They help us to ascertain the territorial extent and reign of the rulers. Sometimes they also provide valuable personal information of the rulers, such as their religion. For example, Samudragupta's coins tell us that he was a good veena player. Next question. What do inscriptions tell us about history? Answer is, inscriptions are reliable sources of information about the history of any period because they provide us names of the kings, the administration of the kingdom, some important event, the extent of the kingdom, etc. The Ashokan inscription and the Allahabad pillar inscription tell us a great deal about the reign of Ashoka and Samudragupta. Next question. What are religious literary sources? Answer is, religious literary sources comprise of the literature that is related to the religion of the people of the time. The Vedas and the Puranas contain details of the rituals, prayers and religious practice of the ancient past. Hence, they are classified as sacred or religious literary sources. Next question. How has India's geography helped in shaping its history? Answer is, the history of India has been greatly influenced by its geographical or physical features like soil type, rainfall, climate, vegetation and environment, which influence the evolution of human culture and their way of life. The Himalayas in the north protect the country from invaders. The long coastline of the peninsular India encouraged foreign trade and many kingdoms flourished in the northern plains. Now coming to the main question E, that is, answer the following question in 80 to 100 words. Means you have to answer them very detailed, long question answers. Let's start. What are the sources of history? How do they help in reconstructing the past? Answer is, the sources of history are the records of the past events. These can be divided into two groups. First one is archaeological source. These include fossil remains, artifacts, tools and implements, edicts and inscriptions, monuments, coins, etc. Artifacts include man-made objects such as pottery, tools, jewelry, seals, and toys. Second one is literary sources. These sources include manuscript, language and religious and non-religious literature. Sources of history help in reconstructing the past by throwing the light on the social, religious and cultural life of the age to which they belong. Monuments give an insight to the architectural style. Artifacts tell us about the kind of life people lived, their occupation and their social setup. And coins give information about the economic condition of the kingdom and its territorial extent. Next question. What is the importance of geographical features of India in shaping its history? Answer is, the history of India has been greatly influenced by its geographical or physical features. In fact, history without geography is incomplete. If history provides the time, the geography provides the space. Soil type, rainfall, climate, vegetation and environment have greatly influenced the evolution of human culture and their way of life. The Himalayas in the north have protected the country from invaders. The long coastline of peninsular India has encouraged foreign trade and many kingdoms have flourished in the northern plains. So this was all regarding the CW work of this chapter. Please, this is my humble request that when you write your CW book, the gap between two words should be maintained. दो वर्ड्स के बीच में जो गैप है उन्हें मेंटेन कीजिएगा. डोंट राइट योर सीडब्ल्यू जस्ट लाइक दैट. सम किड्स डू लाइक दिस. सी फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ आई राइट चूज द करेक्ट आंसर, आई हैव लेफ्ट दिस मच प्लेस इन बिटवीन टू वर्ड्स. बट सम किड्स डू इन दिस वे. चूज द करेक्ट आंसर. Can you see any spacing in between two words? Then how will the teacher identify? Correct? So this is a wrong method. You have to leave the gap between two words. It's okay if you utilize one extra page. It will hardly take one extra page. But your book will look neat and clean. And it will be easier for you to read during the exam. Okay, so chalo, along with this video I am going to send a PDF part 2, CW part 2, in which question answers are covered, and I am hoping you will copy the question answers in your CW book with good handwriting, no spelling mistake and proper spacing. And one more thing, along with this video you will be getting an objective paper which will help you to revise the chapter. Clear kids? So if you have liked this video, please click on the like icon. And see you in the next session. Goodbye.